Individually, my name's Nick.
Hi.
James.
Yes!
Woo! Daniel. Woo! We're gonna do something spooky today. I hope you all like it. And we would like to ask you for a location where a lot of people gather.
Some people thought the church should be dedicated to St. Peter, but most people thought it should be dedicated to St. George. This caused quite a divide in the population of the town. Most people said, you know, why can't we just agree on one name and come to one decision? But the other people were set.
And they said, nah.
And so the townspeople became very angry at one another.
Eventually it became a war. Two sides always opposed. They wouldn't even sit on the same aisle in church. They were always, always apart. Until one fateful, fateful Sunday.
When everyone was gathered together, singing hymns and ignoring their problems. And one little boy crept forward from the back.
And he said, hey. At the end of the day, aren't we just all human? And then the church people were like, whoa, I really resonate with that message of humanity.
But at that moment, a great smash of lightning came down on the church, burning into the ground as though some supernatural force had decided against the townspeople.
It was almost as if their hatred had manifested into a storm just too soon. And from that day forward, the feud continued to the point where by 2017, nobody even knew what had begun it. And the only time the two sides met was in church.
Typical Sunday mass at the church, and well, you can bet your bottom dollar that shit was divided.
St. George's Church had just had a nice new white paint job done on the outside,
with a big red line right down the middle of the church.
At one point it had been a velvet pathway, but now it was so narrow and precise that it was clearly a division.
Somewhere far in the distance, take me to church, please.
On the left side of the red line, there were nice oak pews. And on the right side, there were cherry oak pews.
And outside in the back, there's a lovely garden. One of the only places in the church that was all united in a circle.
Surrounding the church are various farms, houses, filled with people on equal sides of the division.
Behind the altar, Father Patrick was preparing for his mass later that day.
No, it's Ave, not Avo.
You're the Latin major.
I simply think that these are the lines
that might provoke the people, and I wouldn't want to get something like that started.
I mean, I simply think that these lines might be the ones who really would vitalize my oak side of this church.
Okay, oak is a little passe, don't you think? Terry Oak might have a little more of that rejuvenating effect that this town so desperately needs.
You know what, Father? I say we see at the sermon today. Whoever gets a bigger ooh and ah, they'll be right about which is better Latin.
All right, but when I get the biggest amen, you'll know who's ah.
Papa?
Yes, son?
Larry has always been a cherry oak family.
Well, son, it looks nice. It looks very nice. It has a sort of reddish sheen. And that's just how my father did things, and his father did things, and so my great-grandfather did things, and so on and so forth. Till so far back, I honestly can't remember.
What if I don't like cherry oak?
Brandy, I'm so nervous to be joining this new town.
You know what, Martha? You're gonna do great. Everyone is going to love you. Cherry oak is the most prestigious side of the church, and you're gonna fit in just right.
Well, just wait one darn cotton pick minute there. I hadn't quite decided that I'm a cherry oak kind of gal.
Oh, Martha. It's not even a matter of choice. Cherry oak is the decision.
Sure, but I mean, red doesn't look so good on me, and there's a kind of a cute guy I saw in pew 4 on the other side.
We can't cross over to the other side.
Sourdough or whole wheat?
Oh, hello, Father.
Oh! One cherry oak boy and a...
Can I help you with the grocery shop in this place?
Well, sure, if you can reach the shower dough, that'd be great.
Whoops! I'm sorry. I was just distracted. I don't know.
A little odd of you.
Oh, no!
Well, let's try it one more time. Okay.
I've
This is going down whether you want it or not. I'll tell you what.
We have the ceremony set for the 66th hour.
June 6, 2006.
That sounds about right.
You studied?
Of course I studied.
Reverend.
My familiar friend.
To the basement, just like we told you to.
Just don't be afraid to hold back. This is the big day.
You have that.
Wait, I should be holding back.
When the 66th time is right, you go to him and light it all ablaze. Every last one.
This is a purifying fire.
Time to
end.
Righteous fire.
Righteous fire.
Father Patrick, I was wondering if I could just speak to you.
Hello, yeah.
Practicing for your sermon, I'm guessing.
Yeah, right? Exactly. I'm always practicing, always listening to my God.
You see, it's my son Jason. I think he's going to defect.
The oak side. So that's what that.
Do you know anything about this, Father? You just said that.
I heard rumblings around the community.
Patrick, I fucking told you so!
Well, what do you say we do about this? Your dastardly son.
I don't know, it's just like, if there wasn't an oak side to defect to, he couldn't defect.
Himself warm is with one right.
righteous flame, then he has a duty to himself and his constituents to light this flame. So I think now is the time for this flame to rise!
The ceremonial church medallion.